folks, Rich here at RC Informer. Today I have something completely different to show you guys in more ways than one. First off, this is the first Dynam airplane I've had on the channel, guys. Apparently Dynam's being carried now by BitGoHobby.com, so you guys can check that out online and take a look at this really nice Supermarine Spitfire on floats. When I first saw this thing, I was like, wow, that's kind of a fantasy warbird, but as I looked it up, looked at Wikipedia, it was a real airplane, guys. They built about 5 Spitfires on float planes. Spitfires are fun to fly, float planes are fun to fly, and it's really nice to have a sporty warplane on floats. They tested, here's a couple pictures of them, I'll throw some up here. They tested this airplane out a few times to see the viability of a float plane with a fighter, and they tested it out, decided to abandon it, but still, it existed, guys. There really was a Spitfire float plane, so this should be pretty cool. Hopefully I'll have this out at Seth and Joe and all to show everybody if you guys want to come down and see it. Anyway, guys, really nice airplane. I think it's a 1200 millimeter size airplane, runs on a 4-channel. Let's take a look at some of the specs and see how it looks. As we take a quick look at the outside of the box, you can see the wingspan at 1200 millimeters or 47 inches. About the same length overall here, guys. Weight with the battery. Looks like it's got a 600 kV brushless Outrunner there motor. 7-9 gram servos installed, a Tomcat 50 amp brushless ESC. And as advertised, guys, 4-cell 4S battery, 2200 milliamp. This is pretty common size. I have a ton of these, and we probably all do, so it's nice we don't have to get a battery for it. Flying time, 6 to 10 minutes, and we'll see how it goes. Anyway, guys, with that being said, you can see right here all the contents of the box. A little different than a lot of the other manufacturers that actually use foam crates and stuff, and we'll see how the quality of this thing is. There's a decal set in here first to start with. It's kind of neat, actually, how they do this in a box instead of, again, foam. And they just put the fuselage in here, guys, and at first glance, you can see here, I'll pull this thing out of here, and looks really nice. The rest of it I'll get out, guys, and we'll lay out all the parts, and we'll take a look at everything. Here's the layout of all the parts that came out of the box, minus one of the wings and decals, which I'm going to show you guys. But starting here at the bottom is the main fuselage that has the motor, ESC, wiring all in there. Here you have your vertical and horizontal stabilizers, elevators, rudders, all in a real nice package that fit together well. I did a little bit of fitting to see how it all went together. One of the main wing panels fully assembled. The spar connects the two floats right here. 2 propellers, guys, which is really nice. They're giving us 2 props, so there is a spare. These 2 interconnecting dorsal fins that actually have these little landing gear slots, it's kind of ingenious, that fit into where the retracts normally went into, because I think this is a converted airplane from their Dynam's retract version of the airplane. The 2 floats are really nice, guys. You can see the steering servo right here for your dual water rudders, which is really nice. Your canopy here, your bag with all your spars to join your floats together and your wing spars and spinners and all that, and your instructions, guys. It looks like a really nice airplane. Not as great of a finish as some of the more modern planes are, some of the newer ones that you normally used to see in, but it is a budget-minded airplane. Most of the Dynam stuff is kind of a lower fidelity, slightly lower quality, but it's meant to appeal to sort of a more budget-minded airplane. But overall, the finish is real nice, guys. I'll show you here right off the bat the decals that came with this, or the stickers, I believe they are. So you can put on some authentic decals on this thing, guys. So you just peel and stick those, I believe. And then the first thing up, guys, really I'm going to show you is a first wing. The nice thing is even though they put this in a box instead of a foam crate, they did bag everything. So I popped one of these open so I could show you guys firsthand the surface of this. It is a flat finish. Again, a little less fidelity than I am used to seeing. I think some guns go in there. But overall, not too bad, guys. What I don't like is these all these little, I don't even know what you call these things, these surface extensions here, or they're just kind of like, I don't even know what the technical name for those is. You see them on a lot of other airplanes, but there seem to be a lot of them on this plane. Obviously, it has something to do with the production process of it, where you see those little things sticking up, those little raised areas. The top of the wing is pretty much beautiful. Bottom has a lot of this stuff on it, and you'll see those. It would be nice if they could finish those off in future airplanes just to clean it up a bit, but overall not too bad. You can see there where servos are already installed for your ailerons and your flaps. Not real excited about having easy connectors on these. Normally you have a clevis there, but we'll see how those hold up. I have those on a few other airplanes, and we'll see how they hold up for this thing. Also, here's your wiring here for your ailerons, your steering for the tail and your flaps, it looks like. And you can see here your gear well, and that is where your interconnecting dorsals there for your floats actually plug into there as if a retract was going in there, but obviously there's not. There's a wheel cover on here for where the retract went for the retract version of this airplane. And then you got some doublers here to screw your wing to the fuselage. But overall, guys, I'm pretty impressed with it. It's not bad. Again, lower fidelity than some of the other planes we're used to seeing around, but not bad overall, guys. It's a nice finish overall. Now let's get on to some of the other parts. The next main item to show you guys is the main fuselage. You can see the motor in there. The windings are very tight, and it has a real strong force here on the magnet. As I turn this, I can feel it clicking, so it's probably going to put out some decent power overall. Nice engine stack detail, a few rivets. Again, guys, pretty light on the detail. The rivet lines are actually fairly large and deep into here, but I tell you, for what it is, it's very nice. The finish has a nice flat finish. It actually has a nice, you know, wartime look to it, being as flat as it is. As we go along the bottom here, you can see how your wing goes in. Your but two wing halves just connect with a spar. Then that whole thing goes on here, and that's pretty standard for most wings nowadays. All your wires run through there. Your screws go in here. It looks like they are self-tapping screws. I can't really tell right off the bat till I get in there, but instead of machine, I prefer to see machine screws there, but you know, we're not gonna go too crazy with this airplane, I don't think, so it should be sufficient to keep everything in place. As we go along the tail here, you can see here where a tail wheel once went with a set screw, again, on the retract version of this airplane, I believe there was one anyway. And then here's your links or your rods for your rudder and your elevator. I assume those go on with probably some easy connectors, so that's probably why there's no clevis on the end. Again, I'd prefer to see a clevis, but we'll see how those hold up. As long as you tighten them up enough and maybe even file a little flat spot, okay, in that shaft where the screw is gonna go, that'll probably help keep it on as well too. So, but anyway, here's your screw holes where everything passes through to get your elevator and your rudder. It looks like your rudder and elevator go together. They stick in here, and then I think two screws go through the bottom. It looks like about as simple as it is. And then the other side of the fuselage is really nice. It's really kind of impressive they could put this in a box instead of a foam crate, something that's not form-fitted with just a bag around it, and it actually survived the shipping pretty nice, guys. So overall, good finish. There is a canopy right there in that bag that we have to glue on here with the pilot and stuff, so it's bad because you got to glue it on and all that, but it's good because if you want to put a pilot and do cockpit detail, you're all set and ready to go. So this is a magnetic canopy that comes off of here, magnetic rare earth magnet there in the back, tongue and groove up front there that just fits in. And then inside there's your rudder and elevator servos. Real simple stuff, guys. Your speed controller up front that you probably want to secure, and then your wiring harness and so forth. I may use a jumper on this, a converter, adapter, or I may go EC3 or something, but we'll see. But overall, not too bad in here, guys. Battery goes right in here. I'm assuming there's a battery strap or something. This is a little different than I'm used to. Or actually, you know what? I tell you what, the battery actually probably goes right up there. That's it. Fits right up in there. Perfect size for a 4-cell 2200 pack in there to get the CG right. Again, tongue and groove goes in here. We push that down and that secures in place. So overall, guys, I tell you, not bad. For the first Dynam plane I'm showing, quality seems pretty decent. It just looks like there's gonna be some gluing to this where normally I'm used to screwing everything together and going quick. But overall, guys, quality's real nice. Now, since we just looked at the fuselage, it's a good time to look at the horizontal stabilizer and elevator, the vertical stabilizer and the rudder here, guys. And see how they all fit together. The finish on them is really nice. I do see a little blistering here. And these little divot marks again. Somebody's going to chime up on my video and say, those are called this and that. I don't know what these are called. There's some sort of mold mark that comes on there. They seem to stand out a little more on this Dynam airplane than a lot of the other airplanes I've reviewed. But overall, I'd like to see those go away because they kind of stick out a little bit. But finish is nice. Fit is good. Hinges, I don't know if they laminate these at all, but these are probably screaming at me. You can see that's just cracking in the paint, not the foam. The foam actually seems pretty tough. And as I'm looking at this, same thing, foam hinges, I'm seeing a little bit of crack in there, but I think that's just the paint finish, guys. They feel pretty tough there, although they are probably screaming for some foam tack, guys. I'm probably going to run a bead of foam tack across their layer on those just to keep them in place. And as I flip this over here, guys, you can see they have the joiner here for your elevator halves glued in. I'd like to see a little nicer job from the factory come on those, but they do seem to be glued in place pretty good. And as I'm turning them, they do seem to move together pretty decently, and they did a decent job gluing them structurally at the factory, although I'd like to see that smoothed off a little bit, so maybe I'll mess with that. But these fit together actually pretty nice, so it's easy assembly overall, guys. You just kind of pop this thing in place. You can see how that whole section goes in there, just like we sort of talked about. You do have to go ahead and put on, I believe, your horn here and for your rudder, and your horn here for your elevator. And then this whole unit here, guys, it just kind of pops right in to the back there, and then two screws are going to go up through the bottom. So overall, guys, nice horizontal stabilizer and rudder package, and they just go in with two screws. Here's a quick look, guys, at one of the floats and the you know, the interconnecting dorsal fin that connects them all together. Again, guys, really pretty nice, guys. The finish is not too bad. I tell you, it's solid. The whole thing is built nice. A little rougher than I'm used to, but nice, flat, and very war looking, you know. Very nice how it's set together. Plastic rudder package with bell cranks here, guys. There are two water rudders on both sides. There's an interconnecting rod that goes to the other side to steer both of these together, and then another rod that comes up here to steer your one rudder, which again translates to another push rod to steer both at the same time. So actually pretty nice overall. The float itself, I like the fact that they ran some real nice plastic, like a V-hole, along the bottom of this. So really pretty durable. That allows you to put this down without, you know, dulling out your, you know, your V-hole. They did the same with the back here. I'm kind of impressed. Normally places leave this foam, but man, did a nice job on that that hull there, guys. These are your interconnecting, where your two, I think, carbon fiber or fiberglass rods go to join the two halves together, and then this whole package connects to the airplane. You can see here the interconnecting dorsal. I just popped this in place. See, that comes right out. I'll use some foam tack, as usual, to tack glue this whole thing in place. But it fits in there real nice. Here's your dummy retract unit right here, guys, that actually fits into where the actual retract plate goes in. Actually, let's take a quick look at actually how that thing fits in place. I'll actually grab the wing here and show that to you here. Can't do a perfect fitting of it here, but I can get pretty close. You can see how this joins on. It looks like this was the old radiator scoop for the original Spitfire or oil cooler or something. And but since this is a version of the airplane that is a float plane, that's not really part of it. So it looks like you got to run a wire, probably, I'm thinking, back through this channel and up here, okay, for the rudder. And then this piece just fits right down in here, guys, as if you were installing a retract, but obviously you're not. Now, I don't know if this is intended to be glued. You probably can, but I think just putting screwing this in place as if it was a, like I said, it's a dummy retract unit that fits in there. So if you screw those in, I believe, and probably glue this, we'll see what the instructions say. And then that's how your dorsal goes on there for your float. So real easy construction, guys. It looks like they really did a nice job on there. The finish of these parts, like I said, it's a little rougher than I'm used to, but it is a nice finish. I'm usually used to seeing these little dimples right here, the smaller ones instead of these larger ones, because you can see the bottom of the wing has quite a few of them. But you can see this finish. Look at this thing. It's actually very, very nice. So overall, guys, real impressed, real nice quality so far. The last few items to show you guys is the propeller and the parts bag. The prop looks pretty nice. It looks a little bit more flexible than I'd like to see it, but it does seem to be made of like a glass reinforced plastic. It doesn't seem to be just a normal plastic or nylon or something. It looks like it is reinforced with glass, but as I get to setting this thing up, we'll take a closer look and see how they hold up. They did give us a pilot here, guys. Pretty standard looking pilot, but he looks warlike. There are some decals and stuff to put on there. We've got the canopy, a Y harness, probably for ailerons, flaps or something. And the canopy just glues in place. So I'll be gluing that pilot and canopy in without too much detail. I know guys like to really detail their stuff, and you can kind of have at it. There's also a parts bag here with some glue, contact cement, to glue all this together. So you can use this. I'm probably going to use my foam tack, guys, because foam tack is pretty much the best stuff around, guys. Nuts, bolts, screws. So there is a little bit of assembly to this airplane. You can see the tail wheel is not going to be needed because we're not going to do retracts on this thing. I think you could convert this to a retract airplane if you just screw in the floats. You could probably unscrew them and get some retracts for this thing and make a regular retractable gear landing airplane out of this, because they did include the tail wheel right here. So if you do want to go off of the floats and put some retracts, the tail wheel's here for you and it's ready to go. So it looks like they give you some antennas and a screwdriver there, guys. So lots of stuff bagged real nice. You can see your gun detail up front, spinner set up for the four-bladed prop, and these are your interconnecting rods, guys. Looks like the larger one here is your main wing spall. Our carbon, very tough, and then your two interconnectors to connect the two floats together. So that pretty much sums it up, guys, for all the parts that come with the airplane, and so far they look real nice. Last but not least, guys, is the instruction manual, and right in here they do give you a programming guide. I think one side is English, one side is Chinese. I'm not 100% sure, but this shows you how to reprogram your ESC, and then this is the Chinese side, so you got to flip to the other side for here for the English, and it's all on one gigantic page, guys. It shows all the parts, shows throws to put in. We'll see how that goes. I'll report on that more as I fly the airplane. And then here's your center of gravity, guys. We'll see how that goes too. I'll talk about that as we fly the plane. It says 75 to 80 millimeters from the leading edge of the wings, and we'll take a look at that. And all your assembly instructions are right here on this one place. You get the tail on, you move across here, guys, and it looks like it goes from the tail to getting your prop and spinner on here. And then it looks like your guns, gluing your floats together, putting that all on, and getting your wing in place, and that's really it. I don't even think, do they show the wing on there? I'm not really even showing where they actually attach the wing, but that's pretty self-explanatory. Now it shows it right down here. Very brief instructions, guys, but it is a pretty simple airplane to put together, so shouldn't be too much problem. And then, of course, the decal placement right there, they show you where everything goes. But anyway, guys, pretty concise. Looks like fairly easy to understand. Very easy airplane to get together. A little bit of gluing, more than we're used to, but again, guys, first Dynam plane I'm showing on the channel. So we'll get this together as quick as we can and see if we can get it out there. Check for the flight demo. We'll get that out there and fly that for you here as soon as we can, guys. But I'm really excited to get this one out there. Hopefully we'll have this at CEF, Joe Nall, and eWeek for all you guys to see. So come on down to the tent and we'll hopefully be flying this around at the lake there. So anyway, guys, check this out once again at bitgohobby.com. They're carrying all the Dynam stuff now. And I'm really liking this so far. Really nice quality overall, and looks like it should be a cool and a fun airplane to fly around on floats, guys. So anyway, guys, thanks for checking out RC Informer, and as always, guys, we'll see you next time.